Hello everyone, I hope you and your family are well during this very difficult time. As we all know, we all have to make adjustments to keep everybody safe. I have a number of points before handing over to Mr. Bennett, who's got some important information for you. Firstly, if there's anything we can do to help, please do get in touch with us at college. You can either call us or use one of the many new emails we have on our website. I want to thank all our students and parents for ensuring that learning continues. And it is wonderful to see parents posting photographs of their children working hard at home. I know studying at home alone without your friends is difficult. However, learning must continue so we are ready for when the college reopens. Talking of reopening, please try not to speculate about the date. The press are keen to talk about schools opening. As soon as we know, we will update parents and students. Saying this, some students, whose parents are key workers or require school support, are still coming to college each day. If your circumstances have changed and you require the support, please get in touch with us. I'm always amazed by Cowley staff and how they go above and beyond for the students and the community we serve. For example, the hours of lessons prepared online, for over 1,000 phone calls made by staff to ensure our students are safe and well. You may have seen in the press how we've been providing or making PPE equipment for the National Health Service. This continues, and Mr. Jones has made over 1,000 face masks using Cowley 3D printers. Please keep checking our website and social media for updates. Most importantly, keep yourself safe. Follow the government guidelines and look after yourself and your family. I will now hand over to Mr. Bennett for some more important updates.
Good morning and welcome to Pulse TV special edition episode 1, the good news section. Now I get the great job of talking about some of the good news and the best practices you as students from working from home. We've had some great examples of you lot working hard at home, and we appreciate us as teachers how difficult that is. It's a new way of learning, a new way of working, and it brings its own challenges. So we must thank you for all your efforts and for keeping resilient and keeping working hard. It is very, very difficult, and we urge you to stay in a good routine of working every day, doing little bits every day, so that when you come back to school, you're still in those good habits and good routines. Now, it's been great to see lots of you being independent Cowleyans, showing resilience to achieve a task. You might have set about a piece of work that you found difficult, but you've stuck at it. You've been aspirational Cowleyans by trying new things. And I just want to share some of those examples with you. So, during week one of lockdown, I think we're into week four now, but during week one of lockdown, Mrs. Weldon sent out a request on social media asking students to send in pictures of them working from home. And here are a few. We've got Ellis, Molly, Matthew, James, the two Rubies, Nathan, all working out at home, all in front of their computers, all at their desks. And we've even got one from our almost year seven student, Riley, who sent in a piece of work. So we're looking forward to seeing Riley in September, and thank you for sending in your pictures. Now, it's not just our younger students who are continuing to work hard. It is Matthew Griffiths. Matthew is one of our year 13 students, and he has now completed every A-level chemistry past paper available online. And he's got so good at them that when Mr. Jones is marking them, he's getting 100% when they're assessed. So well done to Matthew for working so hard, or continuing to work hard at home. A special mention to Abigail Atherton, year 9. Mrs. Proudlove loved reading your piece of work that you sent in. It was a great read and a fantastic high-level standard of work. Our animal care students will be delighted to know that our various animals, which are scattered between different members of staff all around the town, are being well looked after. Here are some pictures. And even the tortoises are loving isolation. Perhaps a little bit too much, the tortoises, as the female has recently laid 2 eggs. So they're certainly enjoying themselves. Jack Pope, year seven, has been enjoying his science lessons. During isolation, he had a closer look inside a flower, here's the daffodils, and he learnt about what each part of the flower does. And Kyle Hussey, year 10, well, he's been listening to Boris Johnson, and he's been keeping up to date with the news and making sure he does his daily exercise of 1 hour a day. So here he is, taking his rabbit for a walk, as you do. Only in St. Helens that would happen. It's been business as usual for Mrs. Faulkner's year 12 students. They did their business mock exam from home. They sat their 2 hour mock exam paper as planned, had to send in photographic evidence by 8:50 a.m. All the students did, and they were ready for a 9 a.m. start. Harrison Latter in year 9 is our current Caboodle King. He has accessed more work, more science work on Caboodle than any other student at present. Lots of you are doing, and lots of you are using Educake as well in science, which is fantastic. The teachers are getting those reports when you complete a task and replying to them, so that's brilliant. Year 10 dancers will be pleased. Miss Radford said there's going to be more opportunity for practical work when you come back to school, because many of you are working hard on your dance theory logs at the moment. So the more work you're doing at home means more practical work when you come back into school. And here are a couple of examples. So keep going with that. Roisin Cook, an excellent piece of artwork was sent in to Miss K here. And she's loving seeing all the pieces of artwork that the students are sending in. And well done to those students who are trying the culinary skills. We've had lots of pictures of students trying new ingredients, making new dishes. We've got Lucas Bond here, who made enchiladas and sweet potato wedges for his family, and even year 11 Scott Bond, his brother, enjoyed it. And Matthew Sheppy made a delicious chicken curry, so well done to Matthew. And we've also got a clip of our head boy from sixth form, year 13 student Ben Edwards, and Ben has taken to some Garden Olympics, commentated by his mum. He's taking on his dad in a race and he seems to win, but I think the lockdown situation is getting to him. Ben, I think you need to go out for your hour exercise and get out a bit more than the back garden, go around the block. But well done, Ben. Finally, I mentioned to the staff who are working from home, preparing work for the students and reviewing work that's been sent in. It is difficult for staff as well, and we thank you to all staff who are working hard at home and preparing for when the students return. Probably two special mentions for staff. Mr. Jones spent a lot of his Easter using the 3D printers to prepare some PPE equipment for the local hospitals. And that's been in the local news, so that's fantastic from a school point of view, and well done to Mr. Jones. And then Miss Jane in science has been volunteering as a healthcare assistant at Arrow Park, so we wish her well and keep safe, Miss Jane. It's been great to see the piece of work the students have sent in. Lovely to see you working hard from home. If any students want to share a piece of work that they've done or stories of them working from home, then email into school, go onto the Cowley Facebook and post some things, and then I can share them on the next episode of Pulse TV. Please keep working hard. Please keep checking the Cowley website for new pieces of work that are coming online. If you have any worries or any struggles, then there's a list of emails and you can email into certain departments or to the year team, and staff can respond to that. And thank you. It is a difficult time. I'm sure we'll be back to school relatively soon. But the more you can keep in a good routine and the more you can keep that work ethic going, then you'll be flying by the time we're back in school. So thank you. And that's the first edition of Good News on Pulse TV. Thanks very much. Hi, good afternoon, it's Mr. Bennett, and this is the first Cowley Isolation Challenge. I've got my wheelie bin down there. This is called Cowley Get Your Bins Out. Samuel's next to it to help me. I've got a rugby ball. I'm just going to try to show some skills to see if I can get the ball in the bin. You can use a football, you can use a cricket ball, use a golf ball, try and pitch a shot in with your golf club. I'll show you my skills, you see if you can get better than me. Here we go. One. Little kick. It's one out of three. Can anyone beat me?
Yeah. How many? Watch the barbecue. You'd be excited, Rollo.
Here we go, this is it.
Come on.